Greetings from South Africa. My name is Ellen Tise. I'm the Senior Director, Library and Information Services at Stellenbosch University. And I'm also the chair of the South African National Library and Information Consortium. And the reason why I mentioned my sort of second role I would like to use this opportunity and thank you for Taylor and Francis for asking me to participate in their Thursday talk series. The reason why I've mentioned about the South African Library and Information Consortium, because they had been instrumental in the driver of the open access with regard to transformational agreements in South Africa, and we were very pleased that we were able to sign an agreement, a groundbreaking agreement with Taylor and Francis in the beginning of this year, 2024, which now also allow South African researchers. It also includes researchers, institutions from Namibia and also Botswana in Southern Africa to participate in this read and publishing deal with Taylor and Francis. But my focus this morning is to talk more about the experience that we have had here at Stellenbosch University in implementing and really be an advocate for over many years for open science, open access, and which had started with the development of our institutional repositories, and then the last repository that we have implemented was also a research data repository. So we have had many initiatives in terms of an open access publication fund to support researchers to publish in open access forums. And the reasons we did this and why we played such a leading role here at Stellenbosch University was because we wanted to contribute to the university's strategic actions, particularly around research impact, and to ensure that we play a role in making the university's research output more visible. And of course, through that, it can have a greater impact as more people are able to read. And of course, there are also benefits for the researchers in terms of citations, but for us it was more about just in terms of how universities positions themselves, but rather that we want to make sure that the university has an impact on society, and that's why we supported that. But what we found, even though we have had now about more than 10 years, 15 years been an advocate for open access and for all these initiatives at the university, we found that researchers still struggle. And students that they know very, they still don't understand quite what open access publishing is. Some link it to predatory. What we've done is although we've had various other initiatives, we are actually launching a series of open access webinars, and where we're going to, for example, focus on specific topics like how transformational agreements. Transformative agreements have been the South African what is the impact of these agreements on South African institutions. We also want to look at strategies for evaluating and rewarding open access, and then we also want to talk about a webinar on emerging trends and future directions in open access. Important for us here in the Global South around equity and inclusion in open access. And then lastly, we also want to talk about open access as a contribution to the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. So this is where we are going to invite all our researchers, students, but it will also be open to researchers and students in other countries to join, because we will actually bring in speakers also from various other institutions. And I think for us, that is how we want to go forward to really assist and make researchers aware of the benefits of open access. Thank you.